Let's learn how to create a new YouTube channel in 2020 for beginners. YouTube recently launched their new platform for creators. It's now very easy to make and set up a new YouTube account and channel. When you come to YouTube, you'll notice that there's no sign up button, and in fact, instead you need to sign in. YouTube is owned by Google, so to be a creator on YouTube, you need to have a Google account. So you have two options. First, if you already have, say, a Gmail account, you can log into YouTube using your Gmail or Google account details, or you can go ahead and create a brand new Google account. And creating that account is super easy, so let's show you real quick how to do that. Feel free to skip forwards to the next step if you've already got a Google account. When you click create account, you get two options. You can either create an account for myself, which is a personal account, or to manage my business, which is a brand account. I recommend you to choose the second option, regardless of whether you have a business or not. This option allows you to create a custom YouTube channel name, allows you to assign additional team members with different login details to come in and manage a YouTube account. And if you were to create just a personal account, it'll be your personal name that'll be displayed as your YouTube channel. Either way, you're not locked in because you can change from one to the other at a later date and customize your channel name as you see fit. But I'll continue with the business account or brand account. This step's both intuitive and self-explanatory, so we'll skip through it real fast, head on back to YouTube where we can log in using these credentials.
So we'll come on over and sign in.
And now you've got the ability to like videos, post comments, and subscribe to channels. And while you're here, I'd love it if you gave us a thumbs up below and even subscribe to this channel if you're getting some value out of this. All right, you've got yourself a Google account. So come up to the top right and then click create a channel. Then get started. We'll pause there and come back in just a minute. Let's say you've already got a YouTube channel and you want to create another one, or you've got a personal channel, but you want to create a brand account. You'll see that create channel is gone, and instead you want to go to settings and then click add or manage your channels, and then you can click create a new channel. And it's asking you to create a brand account. You won't need a new email address here, you'll just need to put in a new brand name. But let's take it back a step and learn how to make and set up a new YouTube channel on this page here. Here's an opportunity again to create a new YouTube channel either under your personal name or under a brand account name. I recommend you select a brand account, regardless of whether you have a business or not, as this will give you more flexibility later on when you want to create, say, a second or third channel. And this allows you to reserve your personal account name to be the one that you use to subscribe, like, and write comments to other people in other channels, without it necessarily needing to be associated to your brand channel. So we'll go ahead and select this one. So this is where how to start a successful YouTube channel begins, by creating a nice brand name. And as it prompts you here, a good channel name represents you and your content. And don't forget, you can change your name at any time, so you're not locked in, so choose something nice to begin with. I recommend you throw a few ideas around that's relevant to the content that you're making, so it helps people when they're searching for content, they see the name of your channel, and they can understand what it is roughly that you're speaking about. So let's call it Tim's Tech Tutorials for now. Let's check this box, hit create. And success, we've learned how to make a YouTube channel under a brand account. Now let's go about learning how to set up a new YouTube channel. Let's start with everyone's favorite, and that is uploading a profile picture, which might be a picture of yourself or your company logo. This image is super important in that it's shown anywhere where your brand account has activity. It's the first impression for your business. So make sure it's a good one. And remember, it's always going to be shown as quite a small image. So make sure you don't try and fit too much into it and that it's nice and clear or zoomed in. Be sure to pay attention to the requirements of dimensions, file type, and file size. Hopefully you've got some Photoshop skills, you can pull that off. So I'll go ahead and upload my business logo. As prompted here, your description can show up in search results and other places, so it's important to get some nice keywords in here that really talk about what your channel is about. You're limited to 1,000 characters, so try to make it nice and snappy and concise. And as this is just a dummy channel for now, I'm just gonna cheat and copy and paste. Lastly, you want to come down and fill out your external links to your website and your social media accounts. Then finish off by hitting save and continue. And welcome to your brand new channel. Now, although you're ready to start creating and uploading, and you can do that anytime by clicking the create post button and upload a video or go live streaming, but that comes later. There's a few things you probably want to do to customize your channel and change a few settings. So go ahead and click the customize channel button. The main thing you're going to want to do on this page is to add some channel art. Now, this is what visitors will see when they come to your channel. Be aware that your avatar or profile picture won't actually be displayed in this spot. And you'll see over here the links to your social media and the external website that you set up in the previous step. So go ahead and click the Add Channel Art button and it'll come up and tell you the required dimensions for this. What I recommend you to do here is to go over to a free graphic design platform such as canva.com. So let's head over there now. And real quick, once you're signed in, then come over to your template for YouTube, click social media and find YouTube Channel Art. That's going to open up a canvas in the correct dimensions. Now, as the channel art is displayed differently on a desktop, to a mobile, to an iPad, it's good to load in a template that shows what displays on different devices. So I'm going to put this template in. I'm going to link in the description where you can download this from. So as a lot of people are using YouTube on their mobile, you want to make sure that the text in your graphic fits within this box here. And then you can feel free to sprinkle a few extra graphics on the outer side, but nothing too important for describing what the channel is about. Just some nice background colors or graphics or images. So I'll just go ahead here and type in some text, put in a little bit of a background graphic, and you get the idea what we're aiming for. And then you can simply save and download this. And then simply drag and drop that file into your channel art window and you'll get a little bit of a preview as to what it looks like on each device. Then just hit select and that'll save. And then in a moment, you'll get a preview of what it's gonna look like. And to see how it's gonna appear for people coming to YouTube channel, click this one. And there you go. I recommend a nice, clean and simple design that's not too cluttered. This one's a little bit basic, but that's a good start for someone just starting out. Let's head over to YouTube Studio, where all the magic happens behind the scenes on your channel. I mentioned earlier that YouTube recently revamped their entire studio environment. So you can take a little tour here, but I won't do that for now. But over time, you'll get to know these items quite well. You'll find you spend most of your time in the videos and analytics tab. And of course, the dashboard's a nice summary as well. I also recommend you browse the settings just to get your head around that a little bit. Some things you might like to do early on is put in some keywords for your channel. This is similar to in the description, putting things in that make sense about what your channel is about to help people find the channel. Also put in your country if you like, and moving over to advanced settings. You might like to change the setting about kids content early on to set it as a default. And generally, if your videos are not specifically made for kids, say that it's not made for kids at all. Over here in branding, you can put in a little image. I recommend you upload either a logo, but also you can put a subscribe button there because that button will always be there so that people can easily subscribe to your channel. Then under feature eligibility, I recommend you go ahead and verify your phone number because that's going to unlock a few extra features for your YouTube channel that you might like to use later on, including live streaming. So go ahead and do that. It only takes 2 minutes and it's going to be good for you later on. This is again to ensure that you're a person and not a robot. So now that you're verified, just go ahead and go back to your YouTube studio. This channel is now set up and ready to go, just waiting for you to create and upload some videos. Watch this video next. You'll learn how to look good on video calls, on webcam, and in videos in general. It will help you when you make your next video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you over there.